I'm Leah, and here's our top 10 list of tips for writing realistic dialogue.
Number one, read your dialogue out loud. You're going to be able to catch any mistakes, but also any chunk of dialogue that sounds awkward when you're actually hearing it versus just reading it over in your head.
Number two, keep your dialogue grounded in the scene. If your character's in the middle of a coffee shop, rather than having dialogue after dialogue after dialogue, give them action so we can see who is doing what. You don't need it for every sentence or every thought spoken, but it certainly helps to break up the monotony of two talking heads.
Number three, dialogue tags. That's the he said, she said. Keep it simple. Keep it at he said, she said, and if you can use action to infer who's saying what, that's even better. But don't try and get creative because then it just sounds weird, and your readers are going to gloss over the he said, she said anyway, so just keep it simple.
Number four, when using different dialects, proceed with caution. It can be done. Outlander's a really great example, but for the most part, if you're writing an Irish guy, you don't need to have him say everything like an Irish guy would. Just add lad or lass or something, you know, that identifies that he's Irish. Or if you're writing an uneducated character, he might say I ain't instead of I haven't. And you can do simple little things like that that will convey your point, but not have the reader have to work too much to read it.
Number five, people watch, or rather people listen. Go out into the real world to sit and listen to how people talk. All of your characters should sound different, and this is an exercise that can help you do that. And by listening to people talk in their everyday lives, you can get inspiration from that.
Number six, this one's really easy. Keep in mind the age of the characters that you're writing. 90-year-old woman is going to speak differently than her 13-year-old granddaughter, who is also going to speak differently than her 9-year-old sister or brother. Just keep that in mind.
Number seven, skip the boring stuff. Saying hello and goodbye is polite, but when you're writing, you can skip the formalities and just go straight to the good stuff. So skip over all of that, get to the meat and the bones of the dialogue.
Number eight, dialogue is meant to convey how people speak. So remember that when you're writing it, because we don't say, I am going to the store. We usually say, I'm going to the store. I cannot do that. I can't do that. Just be cognizant of that and your dialogue should come across as real. But on that same note, not too real, because a lot of us say things like or and inserting too much of that in your dialogue will also just make it a mess. So there's a fine line, but once you figure out how to balance it, it's all good.
Number nine, give your character something that they always say and readers will always remember them by it. Just make sure that you don't let another character say it, because then that defeats the whole point. But yeah, just give them something that they always say, and then that's their little thing in the story, and it will help differentiate them from other characters even more.
Number 10, sometimes silence speaks louder than words. If character A drops a bomb on character B might choose not to say anything at all, and a lot of times that's more effective for conveying your point as a writer.
And those are our top 10 tips for writing dialogue. Be sure to join us every Monday or Friday when we post a new video, and subscribe, share, all of the buttons are down there. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.